Hi all, today we can discuss about the numericals based on Bragg's law. What is Bragg's law? 2D sin theta is equal to n lambda, where d is the interplanar spacing, theta is the glancing angle, that is Bragg angle, n is the order of diffraction, lambda is the wavelength of x-ray use. Instead of interplanar spacing, if lattice parameter and Miller indices are given, then we can find out the interplanar spacing using the formula A by root of h square plus k square plus l square, where h, k, l are Miller indices values. See the first question. X-rays of unknown wavelength give first order Bragg reflection at glancing angle 20 degree with 212 planes of copper having FCC structure. Find wavelength of X-rays if lattice constant of copper is 3.615 angstrom. So first write the given data. X-rays of unknown wavelength give first order Bragg reflection. So n is equal to 1. At glancing angle 20 degree, theta is equal to 20 degree. With 212 planes, that is HKL values are 212, of copper having FCC structure, find the wavelength of X-ray. So we have to find out the lambda. If lattice constant of copper is, that is lattice constant is A, is equal to 3.615 angstrom. So, we want to find out the wavelength of X-ray use. So, from the Bragg's law, 2D sin theta equal to n lambda. Wavelength lambda we can find out using the formula 2D sin theta divided by n. Where theta, m are given, but instead of d, lattice constant A is given. So, we can find out the interplanar spacing using the formula A by root of h square plus k square plus l square, where A is 3.615 angstrom divided by root of h is 2 square, k square is 1 square and l square is 2 square. That is 4 plus 1, 5 plus 4, 9. 9 root is 3. 3.615 divided by 3, that is 1.205 angstrom. So, we can substitute the values here, that is 2 into d is 1.205 angstrom into sine theta, that is sine 20 divided by order of diffraction is 1. On calculating, we will get 0.824 angstrom. Now the second question, the first order diffraction is found to occur at a glancing angle of 9 degree. Calculate wavelength of X-ray and glancing angle for second order diffraction if spacing between adjacent plane is 2.51 angstrom. First order diffraction, so n equal to 1, occur at a glancing angle of 9 degree, so theta equal to 9 degree. Calculate the wavelength of X-ray, that is lambda we have to find out, and the glancing angle for second order diffraction, that is we have to find out the theta for n equal to 2. If spacing between adjacent plane is 2.51 angstrom, that is spacing between adjacent plane is d, that is given 2.51 angstrom. Lambda we can find out using 2d sin theta by n. So substitute the values, 2 into d is 2.51 angstrom into sine theta is sine 9 degree divided by n is equal to 1. So on calculating, we will get 0.7853 angstrom. Second, we have to find out the glancing angle for the second order diffraction. So 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. So sin theta is equal to n lambda divided by 2d. Here theta we have to find out for n equal to 2. So it is n is 2 into lambda we already got now, 0.7853 angstrom divided by 2 into d is 2.51 angstrom. On calculating, we will get 0.3129. So theta is equal to sine inverse of 0.3129, that is 18.23 degree. See this question. The Bragg angle for 220 reflection from nickel is 38.2 degree when X-rays of wavelength 1.54 angstrom are employed in a diffraction experiment. determine the lattice parameter of Snicker. So first write the given data. The Bragg angle for 220 reflection, HKL values are 220. From nickel is 38.2 degrees. That is theta is equal to 38.2 degree. When X-rays of wavelength 1.54 angstrom, that is lambda equal to 1.54 angstrom, are employed in a diffraction experiment, determine the lattice parameter, that is A equal to. So we have to find out the lattice parameter. So lattice parameter we can find out from the formula D equal to A by root of H square plus K square plus L square. HKL values are given, but we don't know the value of D. So D value we can find out from the Bragg's law, that is 2D sine theta equal to N lambda. D equal to N lambda divided by 2 sine theta. So N is not given, so we can take the N as 1. Into lambda is 1.54 angstrom divided by 2 sine theta, that is sine 38.2 degree. So on calculating we will get 1.245 angstrom. So this is the interplanar spacing. Now we can find out the lattice parameter A is equal to D into root of H square plus K square plus L square. D is 1.245 angstrom into root of H square plus K square plus L square, that is 2 square plus 2 square plus 0 square, that is 1.245 into root of 8 angstrom. On calculating this, we will get 3.52 angstrom. Okay. Now, next question. Calculate the longest wavelength that can be analyzed by a rock salt crystal of spacing D equal to 2.8 angstrom in the first order. Calculate the longest wavelength, that is lambda maximum, that can be analyzed by a rock salt crystal of spacing is equal to 2.82 angstrom for first order, that is N is equal to 1. So we can find out the lambda maximum from 2D sin theta is equal to N lambda, that is lambda is equal to 2D sin theta divided by N. So for lambda to be maximum, N should be minimum, that is N is 1, that is already given. Another thing is that the sin theta should be maximum. So the maximum value of sin theta is equal to 1. So we can find out the longest wavelength by putting sin theta theta is 1, that is 2d by n, that is equal to 2 into 2.82 angstrom divided by 1, that is 5.64 angstrom. See the next question. Calculate the maximum order of diffraction if X-rays of wavelength of 0.819 angstrom is incident on a crystal of lattice spacing 0.282 nanometer. First we can write the data. Calculate the maximum order of diffraction if X-rays of wavelength lambda is equal to 0.819 angstrom is incident on a crystal if lattice spacing means D equal to 0.282 nanometer. What we want to find out? We want to find out the maximum order, that is N maximum. To find the N maximum in the Bragg's law, 2d sin theta equal to N lambda, sin theta must be maximum. What is the maximum value of sin theta? That is 1. So for N maximum, sin theta is equal to 1. That is 2d is equal to N lambda. So N maximum is equal to 2d divided by lambda, that is 2 into 0.282 nanometer 10 raised to minus 9 meter divided by lambda, that is 0.819 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. On calculating this, we will get 6.886. So what will be our maximum order? This answer is less than 7. We want an integer. So the maximum order is equal to 6. Okay, don't approximate this to 7. Even if it is 6.9, then also you take the maximum order as 6. Next question. If X-rays of wavelength 1.549 angstrom is reflected from a crystal with interplanar spacing of 4.255 angstrom, calculate the smallest glancing angle and highest order of reflection. So smallest glancing angle, that is theta minimum, and highest order of reflection, that is n maximum. So we want to find out minimum glancing angle and maximum order. So first we can calculate the minimum glancing angle. So minimum glancing angle, what's the condition required? 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. So in that, for minimum theta, the order must be minimum. That is, for theta minimum, this n must be minimum. So the minimum value of n is n equal to 1. On substituting in the Bragg's law, we will get sin theta is equal to n lambda divided by 2d. So substitute this n as 1. So that is lambda is 1.549 angstrom divided by 2 into d is 4.255 angstrom. On calculating, we will get 0.182. So this is sin theta minimum. So we can find out the minimum glancing angle as sin inverse of 0.182, that is 10.48 degree. Okay, this is the first part. Now second part, we want to find out the maximum order. So what is the condition for maximum order? For maximum order, sin theta must be maximum, that is sin theta is equal to 1. That is, maximum order is equal to 2d by lambda, that is equal to 2 into 4.255 angstrom divided by lambda is 1.549 angstrom. On calculating, we will get this as 1.49. So it is less than this 6. So what will be the maximum order? Maximum order possible here is 5. Okay. See the next question. Monochromatic high energy X-rays are incident on a crystal. If first order reflection is observed at an angle 3.4 degree, at what angle would second order reflection to be expected? If first order reflection is observed at an angle 3.4 degree, that is, if n equal to 1, theta is equal to 3.4 degree, at what angle would second order reflection to be expected? Then if n equal to 2, then what will be glancing angle? So we can write the formula first. 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. Here, for both the cases, the X-rays are same, that is, wavelength is same. Also, it is incident on the same plane. For we are considering two orders, the plane is same. That is, lambda is same and also d same. So, it is sin theta is equal to n lambda divided by 2d, where lambda is same and also d same. That is, sin theta is directly proportional to the order of diffraction. Therefore, sin theta 1 by sin theta 2 is equal to n 1 divided by n 2. So, on substituting the value of n 1, n 2, and this is n 1 theta 1, n 2 theta 2. So, here sin theta 1, that is sin 3.4 divided by sin theta 2 is equal to n 1 is 1, n 2 is 2. So we want to find out the sin theta 2. So sin theta 2 is equal to 2 into sin 3.4. We will get it as 0.1186. So what will be theta 2? Theta 2 is sin inverse 0.1186. That is 6.81 degree. See the next question. The unit cell dimension A of sodium chloride lattice is 5.63 angstrom. If X-ray beam of wavelength 1.1 angstrom fall on a family of planes with a separation of A by root 5, how many orders of diffraction are observable? So it is given that A of sodium chloride lattice is 5.63 angstrom. That is, lattice parameter is 5.63 angstrom. If X-ray beam of wavelength, that is lambda equal to 1.1 angstrom, fall on a family of planes with a separation. So, separation means interplanar spacing, that is A by root 5. Then, how many orders of diffraction are possible? That is, what is the maximum value of order of diffraction? So, to find out the order, we have the formula 2d sine theta divided by lambda. For maximum order, the sine theta value is 1, that is 2d divided by lambda. So it is 2 into d is a by root 5. A is given 5.63 angstrom divided by root 5 into here lambda, that is 1.1 angstrom. So on calculating, we will get it 4.578. So this value is less than 5, that is n equal to 4. That is, 4 order of diffractions are possible. Next question. Monochromatic X-ray beam of wavelength lambda equal to 5.8189 angstrom is reflected strongly for a glancing angle of theta of 75.86 degree in the first order by certain planes of cubical crystal of lattice constant 3 angstrom. Determine Miller indices of possible planes. So, it is given that wavelength is 5.8189 angstrom. It is reflected strongly for a glancing angle 75.86 degree in the first order, that is n equal to 1, by certain planes of cubical crystal of lattice constant 3 angstrom, that is A equal to 3 angstrom. Determine Miller indices of possible planes, that is, we want to find out the value of Miller indices. Since the lattice constant is given, we can find out the Miller indices from the formula D equal to A by root of x square plus k square plus l square, but we want to know the interplanar spacing. So interplanar spacing we can find out from the formula 2d sine theta is equal to n lambda. So here d is equal to n lambda divided by 2 sine theta, that is n is 1, lambda is 5.8189 angstrom divided by 2 sine 75.86. so on calculating this, we will get it as 3 angstrom. So from the interplanar spacing, we can find out the value of root of h square plus k square plus l square using this formula, that is root of h square plus k square plus l square is equal to a divided by d. That is, A is given as 3 angstrom divided by D, we got now as 3 angstrom, that is equal to 1. Root of h square plus k square plus l square equal to 1, that means h square plus k square plus l square is equal to 1. So now it's clear that the possible values of HKL are 100. So the Miller indices belongs to the family of 100. That is, the possible values are 100, 010, 001, also 1/00, 01/0, 001. So these are the Miller indices possible in this case. So if you are writing the HKL values in the parenthesis, that means it belongs to the family. So here 6 members are belong to the family. So any of this combination is possible for this case. See the next question. In comparing the wavelength of two monochromatic X-ray lines, it is found that line A gives first order Bragg maximum at a glancing angle of 30 degree to the smooth face of a crystal. Line B of non-wavelength of 0.97 angstrom gives third order maximum at a glancing angle of 60 degree with the same face of the crystal. Find wavelength of line A. That is, we have two lines, line A and line B. The line A gives first order Bragg maximum, that is n equal to 1, at a glancing angle of 30 degree. And the line B of non-wavelength of lambda is equal to 0.97 angstrom gives third order maximum at a glancing angle of 60 degree with the same face of the crystal. That is, for both the lines, the interplanar spacing D is same. Find the wavelength of line A. So this is the first case. This is the second case. So how can we find? We can use the Bragg's law. 2d sine theta is equal to n lambda. We want to find out the lambda. So lambda is equal to 2d sine theta divided by n. So here for both the lines, the phase is same. That is, interplanar spacing is same. So we can write from this equation that lambda is directly proportional to sine theta by n. That is, lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to sine theta 1 by n1. Here n2 divided by sine theta 2. So on substituting the value, sine theta 1 is sine 30 divided by n1 is 1 into n2 is 3 divided by sine 60. So sine 30 value is 1 by 2 into 3 divided by sine 60 is root 3 by 2. So 2 and 2 will cancel, 3 by root 3, root 3. So here lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 is 0.97 angstrom. So lambda 1 is equal to 0.97 angstrom into root 3. So on calculating this, we will get 1.68 angstrom. The wavelength of the unknown X-ray line is 1.68 angstrom. One last question. An X-ray beam of wavelength 0.71 angstrom is diffracted by FCC crystal of density 1.99 into 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube. Calculate interplanar spacing for 200 planes and glancing angle for second order reflection from these planes if the molecular weight of the crystal is 74.6 amu. X-ray beam of wavelength 0.71 angstrom, so lambda equal to 0.71 angstrom, is diffracted by a FCC crystal of density 1.99 into 10 raised to 3 kilogram per meter cube. Calculate interplanar spacing, that is D, for 200 planes and glancing angle for second order reflection from these planes if the molecular weight of the crystal is 74.6 amu. So we want to find out the interplanar spacing and the glancing angle. So interplanar spacing we can find out from the formula D is equal to A by root of H square plus K square plus L square. So for that we want to find out the lattice constant A. So to find the lattice constant, in the question they are given the density and the molecular weight. So we know that density is equal to mass by volume. So here the mass is m in the AMU is given. So to convert it into kilogram, we have to divide it by Avogadro number. And volume is, if A is the side of the cube, then A cube is the volume. Now here the crystal given is FCC. So we have to multiply it with the number of atoms in the FCC crystal. So from this equation, we can find out the lattice constant as, on cross multiplying and rearranging, NM divided by rho NA raised to 1 by 3. So for FCC crystal, the number of atoms is 4 into molecular weight is 74.6 divided by density given is 1.99 into 10 raised to 3. Avogadro number is 6.02 into 10 raised to 26 per kilogram mole. We are writing per kilogram mole. So raised to 1 by 3. On calculating this, we will get 6.26 angstrom. Now we got the lattice constant. So we can find out the interplanar spacing. D200 is equal to A divided by root of H square plus K square plus L square. That is 6.26 angstrom divided by root of 2 square plus 0 square plus 0 square. That is 4, root is 2. On calculating, we will get it as 3.13 angstrom. Next, we want to find out the theta. For that, we can use the Bragg's formula. Sine theta is equal to n lambda divided by 2d. So, we want to find out the glancing angle for n equal to 2. So, 2 into lambda is 0.71 angstrom divided by 2 into this interplanar spacing that is 3.13. So, what is theta? Theta is equal to sine inverse 0.71 divided by 3.13. So, on calculating, we will get it as 13.11 degree. So, you try more questions. All the best.